하나님께서 에르시 properties of Edison. Under this subheading, let us study some properties of Edison. What is the first property? If we add a zero to a number, if we add zero to any number, we get back the same number. We get back the same number. A zero added to a number does not change the value of the number. So when zero is added, when zero is added to any number, its value does not change. Value does not change. Okay. Example. Take any number. Number you take, suppose 730. Add zero to this. Add zero to this. Then again we get back the same number. 730 number. Is there any change in the value of this number? There is no change in the value of this number. The same number only we are getting by adding 0. Because 0 has no value. That's why here when 0 is added to any number, its value does not change. That is the first property. In the second property, what is the second property here? 1 added to a number gives the successor of the number. Successor of the number. One is, if one add to a number, gives the successor of the number. Okay. Suppose, so here let us write that part. If one is added to a number, one is added to a number, then we get the successor, then we get its successor. Successor. Okay. Take a number, example. Take a number, suppose 30. To this number add 1, then how much we get? 14. 14 is the successor of 13. 14 is the successor of 13. That means we are getting the next number. So the successor of 13 is 14. Successor of 13 is 14. That is the second property of it. Now what is the third one? If two numbers are added to any whole number, if two numbers are added in any order, their sum remains the same. The sum remains the same. If two numbers are added in any order, the sum remains the same. Two numbers are added in any order. In any order. The sum remains the same.
the summary means the two numbers are added in any order, the summary means the same. For example, take two numbers, 13 and 12, take. First 13 taken, next 12. First 13 is taken, next number is 12. Add 13 plus 12, that means 25. Now, change the order. In any order, I told, that's why order change. First 12 you take. 2 is 39, then 25 only we add. Same. The sum remains the same. Same answer we got. Order changed, but the result is same only. That's why order of changing the numbers does not affect the sum. So what we write here, 13 plus 12 is same as 12 plus 13. Both are equal to 25 only. This is the order property. Okay. Now, let us go to one more property. What is the property here? If three or more numbers are added in different groups, their sum remains the same in all cases. For the children. If three or more numbers are added, okay, in different groups, the sum remains the same. So, changing the group of four, if three numbers if three numbers are added in different groups, the result is same. For example, you see, 7, 5 and 4, take three numbers. Changing the group of numbers, we add now, changing the group of numbers, we add. 7 and 5, take as one group. After that, 5 and 4, the two numbers we can take it as a group. Here 7 and 5, the two numbers were grouped. Here 5 and 4, the two numbers were grouped. Now, in the next, another group of numbers, 7 and 4 you take now. 7 and 4. Group is changed. Third number is what? 5. So here grouping of numbers is different. Grouping of numbers is different. In different groups, we are showing the addition. But the result is same only. Observe here. 7 plus 5 is 12. 12 plus 4 is 16. 12 plus 4 is 16. We got 16. Here, 7 plus, 5 plus 4, 9. 7 plus 9 is 16. Here, 7 plus 4 is 11. 11 plus 5 is 16. These are all representing the same number. Same number we are getting. 16 only. In all these cases, 16 only we are getting. Same result we are getting. Okay. Here what we change the order of grouping the numbers we change. In the case 1, 7, 5 taken as a group. to the total of 4 is added. Here, 5 and 4, the two numbers are taken as a group. Okay. To that total 7 added. Here, 7 and 4 has been taken as a group. Okay. To the total added 5. In all the three cases, we are getting the same answer. That's why grouping in adding the grouping of in adding the numbers, grouping of changing the group of numbers does not giving any effect in the result. Same answer only we are getting. This is the okay property. Now, exercise 2.3, see, in this exercise 2.3 now, some objective type questions are there, 2.3. Some objective type questions are there. Fill in the missing numbers, fill in the missing numbers. Filling the missing numbers. Okay. Let us take some problems in this objective exercise. 9999 to this number, add 1. By adding 1, what we get? Here, I told you, if 1 is added to any number, then we get the next number. Next number, that means the successor, we can get the successor of the number. What is the successor of 9999? What is the successor of 9999? 10,000. That means this is the successor of 9999. That means we are getting the next number. That means successor we are getting. Now come to one more question here. Dash plus 0 is equal to 9888.
Dash plus 0 is equal to 9888. See this.
Here number is not mentioned. To this number, what is added? 0 is added. 0 is added to a number. According to the property, what we'll get the we'll get back the same number only. If we add 0 to any number, we get back the same number. That means 9888. Okay. To this number, here 0 is added. Then we get back the same number only, that means 9888. Now, one more question study here. 84,380 plus dash is equal to that is equal to 84,380 here plus what is to be added for this number to get 84,400. Okay. How can you find this number? How can you find this number? Sum of the two numbers is 84,400. This is the first number. This is the second number. This is the sum of the two numbers. Here, first number is there. Second number not given. This is first number. This is the second number. This is equal to sum of the two numbers. Sum of the first and second.
first and the
second.
Yeah.
How can you get the second number? If you want to get the second number, from this sum, subtract the first number. Subtract the first number. How can you get the second number? From the sum of the two numbers, subtract the first number. That means here, so second number is equal to, how can we get here? From the sum, 84,400. From this sum, what we have to subtract? First number subtract. 380. If we subtract this, okay, we can get the first, second, okay, subtraction. 84,380. Subtract 0 minus 0. 0. Here we can't subtract 8 from 0. So ask borrow from the before class. That's why your 0 becomes 10. 10 minus 8 is 2. 4 has given borrow. It has given borrow. That's why 3 only here. 3 minus 3, 0. 4 minus 4, 0. 8 minus 8, 0. So what is the number we got here after subtraction? 20. Okay. 0 has no value here. That's why 20 is the second number. Therefore, the second number is 20. So, in the blank, what will it? 20 will it. Like this, so we can find the blank answer. Now, 82,643, 2000, this is one more question we are taking. That is 82,643. Question number what here? 10. 82,643 plus dash. 82,643 plus dash. Here number is not mentioned. The in this blank we have to find the number. That is equal to 735. 735 plus 82,643. What is the number in this plan? I told you, what is that order property? What is the order property? We can add two numbers in any order. Okay. We can add the two numbers in any order. But the sum does not change. Two numbers, take two numbers. In different order, add the two numbers. And observe. Then we can say that the sum does not change. Here, 82,643 plus, what is the next number here? 735. Here, first 82,643, second number is 735. Here, 735 taken as a first number. 735 is taken as a first number. Next number, what? 82,643. Numbers are same only, same number, but order is different. Numbers are same. So, it gives the same result. It gives the same answer. Answer same only we can get by adding these two numbers in a different order. Your order does not change the value of the sum like this. Okay, children.